Make your point on the News Hour. Join Arnab every night on the News Hour with your question. Ask your question and join the debate.
The rapists are still on the run. In fact, they have released CCTV footage which is being presented as an alibi for the accused. The cops are now questioning the rape survivor rather than questioning the accused. Are the cops in a way attempting to malign the rape victim? Let's listen in to some reactions.
Family here of the girl alleges that the police is not looking at the case closely. Now they allege that it's the same set of, you know, five people who had gang raped her way back in 2013 who've done the same again. She was forced to compromise, and because she did not do it, she's been asked to pay the price.
Yes, these things came to our knowledge, but till now nothing is being proven, and the accused, which are named in earlier case also, they are being interrogated in this case also, and we got some facts like their locations were different on that day, so they need to be cross-checked.
Okay, and that's an important point that you make, that there are obviously certain facts that you need to look at it. Has the girl been able to give an official statement before a magistrate under 164?
No, a statement under 164 CRPC is not being registered till now. The girl says that she is not in a position to do so, and the moment she will be able to give the statement, we'll get it recorded.
Prashant is joining us on the phone line. Prashant, is this believable when you hear the police statement saying she's not in a condition to make a statement? But we did hear media speaking to the victim, and she did recount the entire horror story. So how is it that she's not okay to give a police statement?
You know, this is what is unbelievable, and this is what...
Okay. Hello. Yes, continue. Yes.
Hello.
All right, I think there is a problem with the audio link there. We'll try and get Prashant back on the line. But several questions now being raised on that entire Rohtak rape case, because the police, it seems, are raising some doubts on the victim's statement as well. Some anomalies on the location of the incident being raised. Let's listen into some more reactions.
अभी तक बात ये हुई है कि इंक्वायरी जो चल रही थी अभी, क्योंकि लड़की ने 164 का बयान नहीं दिया, जब तक लड़की स्टेटमेंट नहीं देगी तो आरोपियों के जिन जिन के नाम लिए हैं उसने, उनके खिलाफ तुरंत कार्रवाई बनती है. तो लड़के जो है वो पुलिस के कस्टडी में ही है. जो सुबह बात मेरी एसपी साहब से हुई है तो वो अब तुरंत गिरफ्तार जो है इसमें किए जाएंगे. हम सिर्फ लड़की की स्टेटमेंट के लिए इसीलिए आज आए हैं कि क्यों डिले हो रहा है.
और एक और बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट बात है, जो यहाँ की पुलिस है वो तो ये कहती है कि अक्यूज ने हमें सीसीटीवी फुटेज दिया है, वो ये कहते हैं कि हम घटना के टाइम कहीं और थे. तो पुलिस इस वर्जन को बाहर क्यों ला रही है, पुलिस लीक क्यों कर रही है? क्या ऑलरेडी पुलिस ने डिसाइड कर लिया है कि विक्टिम की ही सारी गलती है?
बिल्कुल, इस बात के मैं बिल्कुल खिलाफ हूँ. पहले से कुछ भी डिसाइड नहीं किया जा सकता. हो सकता, क्योंकि रेप जो है ये मैनिपुलेटेड था और पहले से डिसाइडेड करके ही पूरा प्लान्ड रेप था.
आवर गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग वेरी सीरियस व्यू ऑफ इट. Three of the accused have been arrested and teams have been formed for the arrest of the remaining persons. And nobody will be spared. A case is also pending in the High Court of the previous incident when it happened during previous government's regime in 2013. On that time also, all the fives were not arrested. No, only two were charged, and she had filed a case in the High Court under Section 139, and we are waiting the decision of the High Court also. Whatsoever High Court will say, we will do it. She is insisting that there were five persons, but out of five, only two were charged, three were freed. That is also a serious matter, and High Court will take some decision regarding this.
It's the most shocking incident which has come to light. There needs to be a thorough investigation. All the culprits need to be brought to book, not just the perpetrators of this heinous crime, but also if within the system concerning some officers, etc., there has been lapses, all those aspects need to be inquired into, looked into. Alongside, the Haryana government should also, I demand a white paper by Haryana government on the law and order situation in Haryana. Why, what is the reason why in the last 2 years the crime graph in Haryana, and especially the heinous crimes, murders, dacoities, rapes, the crime graph is on an uptick. A state which was considered a safe haven, as far as law and order is concerned, safe for investment purposes, safe for its people, citizens, now suddenly has become, is fast becoming the crime capital of the country. The state of the government also needs to put out a statement, and they need some explaining to do.